Well, hello everybody. Here's another edition of the Poem Mash Show. We're glad that you could join us today. Got another great interview coming up in just a couple minutes. But before we get into that, if you like this episode, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell right there, and you're always going to get the latest interviews whenever they're available. And of course, you can always use our comment section to let us know what you think. And if you'd like to, you can like our Facebook page, facebook.com/PoemMashTV. And feel free to like the page and inbox us, comment things you see there. We'd love to hear from you there. And we also have email, obviously. Just email us at PoemMashTV, all one word, at gmail.com. Which you can use not just if you're a band or solo artist, but if you're a fan, you know, you can use that as well. And we'll take care of you there. And don't forget, every Wednesday at 6 p.m. Central on Roku channel Small World TV, one of my episodes will be on there. And we hope you'll check that out. And we'll repeat all this at the end of the closing credits, so stay tuned for that. In just a moment, from Virginia Beach, Virginia, we have Tim Beasley. And he's not just a tribute artist. He tributes over 100 artists and celebrities. And I know that you're really going to like this guy. And we'll get to that in just a moment. But here's a quick word from Click Jam. Don't go away.
We got history, got me feeling the nostalgia when you look at me, thinking about what could.
Okay, we're back, and here's the interview portion of our show, and this time we have Tim Beasley, and he's from Virginia Beach, Virginia, and we're glad to have you here. Thanks a lot for coming, Tim.
Well, very glad to be here. A lot of people don't know my name. They know my shows, and the reason why they know the shows is because of the monikers, my trademarked Vegas Tributes, and the Martini Men, two completely different chunks of entertainment in a variety of tributes. That's a good way to put it.
And he does just about anybody, well, not everybody, obviously, but he does a lot of tribute artists. We've had some tribute artists here, but he can do quite a bit of them. So,
well, it's interesting. Yeah, I've got roughly 100. I stopped counting at 100. I'm like Rich Little, but however, I do the song and dance too. I don't just do the voices. I do the full package from head to toe, the complete characterization, the complete performance of 100 different celebrities from rock music, culture, popular music, Las Vegas style, country music. And that's just the music end. And then we've got TV stars, film stars, iconic characters from history, politics, sports. I mean, you know, it's, you look at my website, you'll see what I'm talking about. A lot of people say, how do you do so many of these different varieties? I go, well, I've been in it for 35 years. I'm like a doctor of impersonations. You know, you practice all these years, you're all set up, you've got experience, and you got to be an actor under all of these. And a lot of people are, you know, tribute stars because they particularly look like somebody, or maybe they sounded like somebody, and they get into business for that reason. Myself, I got into business because first, I'm an actor. And that particular skill is very handy also in the occupation of being a master of ceremonies, because I can run any show. It doesn't matter where it is, what event. I'm a master of ceremonies. I'm an actor. I'm a variety tribute performer. And that's what I've been doing for 35 years.
Okay. Well, how did you know, realize that you could do this? I mean, did you know early on you could impersonate
people? Oh, yeah. For heaven's sakes, I've been an entertainer for years as a kid, even. I started out back in the days of high school, back in the days before VCRs and DVRs and all that. I was fortunate enough, my parents let me watch The Tonight Show with Johnny Carson. And I'd go back to high school the next day because I was a pretty good student. I got really good grades and I could stay up late at night and watch adult TV. This is back in the late 60s, mid to late 60s. And I'd go back to school and out on the smoking block. Yes, they actually allowed smoking in high schools back then. I'm showing my age. And the guys would all gather around and say, Beasley, what was on The Tonight Show last night? Because they couldn't watch it. Your parents wouldn't let them. And I was like, oh, you should have seen Johnny Carson. Boy, he was in fine form. He had Zsa Zsa Gabor on there. And he did that famous skit about Zsa Zsa and her cat. Ah, hey, well, we've got a really great show for you tonight. And Johnny Carson is how I got started. I started doing Johnny Carson monologues for my high school buddies. And then after that, I found out I was pretty good at jingle writing and winning radio station contests with my silly creations. And in 77, I did my first professional appearance as Johnny Carson and also as the other John
Lennon of the Beatles.
Yeah, with the granny glasses, the long hair, the white jacket, the guitar. So I actually had a show called The Two Johnnies. And I would be Johnny Carson to open up. Ah, boy, we got a really great show for you. A rock star, icon, John the Walrus Lennon. And I'd come out as John Lennon after I did my comedy and wow everybody with, you know, Revolution, Imagine, Twist and Shout, and all those songs. So actually, I wore myself out in that area because, you know, you only can do so much in your old hometown. So I moved to the East Coast. I said, that's where the action is. And once I got to Virginia Beach, well, that's mid-Atlantic. I'm halfway between New York and Boston and also between Atlanta and Miami. So I'm right in perfect grounds to do both, North and South. So after years of being represented by a lot of agents before the days of the internet, I had accumulated probably 25 or 30 of my musical tribute shows that I do, which again are classic rock and roll. Buddy Holly, I've actually performed with Lou Gramm of Foreigner at a big music festival in Clovis, New Mexico, where I was Buddy Holly. Clovis is the home of where Buddy Holly did all of his great recordings. I've been Mike Love, as I was talking about, from the Beach Boys. Roy Orbison. Yes, Roy Orbison. Been doing Elvis for years. I don't even want to talk about Elvis. I got probably 100, 500 different shows I've done with him. Bobby V. I like to diversify. I got Ricky Nelson I perform, Bobby V, Dion, Paul Anka, Jerry Lee, the Killer Lewis. I look a whole lot like Jerry Lee. And so doing those rock and roll classics led me to doing the Las Vegas classics, Frank Sinatra, Old Blue Eyes, Tony Bennett, Dean Martin, of course, Bobby Darin, Tony Bennett, even Tom Jones, Rod Stewart, Neil Diamond, and Billy Joel. Now, these are my music shows. And when I do these shows, people look at me and say, how the heck can you be Billy Joel? It's all theatrics and makeup. I got the music, I do the voices, I do the manners, I turn into my stars. So I've got these variety of different shows. One would be like the Martini Men. That's classic Vegas. Frank Sinatra and Dean Martin teamed up with maybe Bobby Darin or Tony Bennett. Or Las Vegas Live, where I'm Rod Stewart, Neil Diamond, Tom Jones. Or I'm Country Gents, where I'm Kenny Rogers, Willie Nelson, Johnny Cash, and some real unique ones, Charlie Rich, mm-hmm. and Mac Davis. So I've got like a five stars in the country music that I perform. So the main thing is, being an entertainer, I stay busy because I've got such a wide palette of different acts. And these, because I create them as I need them. A lot of these shows have been custom production. People say, you know what? We really would like to have, Paul Anka come and do a show. And I say, no problem. Give me 2 days. I'll learn all the songs. I'll learn how to do the mannerisms, the costuming, and I turn into the character that they want. I call it, this behind me, by the way, is my Vegas Tributes cloning labs. So it's top secret. That's why it's all blocked off.
That's quite impressive, all those impressions you could do. As you mentioned Rich Little earlier, it would be interesting if you met Rich Little and did some of those impressions for him. I'm sure he would be impressed.
Well, I met his girlfriend. That's close as I've gotten to Rich Little. He had a lady friend up in Atlantic City. Mm-hmm. And so that's as far as I'll take that story. Mm-hmm. But we're kind of somewhat in the same business. My voices, I used to do a lot of radio commercial drops as impersonations, like, you know, John Wayne or characters from Green Acres, like Pat Buttram. Remember him? Like, Mr. Douglas, this is a brand new 1929 Siesta pickup truck, you know, or comical characters, Jed Clampett, country guys, or for heaven's sakes, the guys from all the TV shows like Crazy Guggenheim from Jackie Gleason. or even the Cowardly Lion from The Wizard of Oz, Rod Serling from the Twilight Zone, or, you know, you name it, I did it. I've got reels and reels of all these things I did over the years. And so put them all together, I can basically just pull a character out as I need. And if somebody wants a certain character, even if it's a historical character like Teddy Roosevelt, George Washington, Abe Lincoln, General Patton, I do all these. I'm very lucky. And it all comes from years and years and years of rehearsals, practice, acquiring and practicing these characters.
All right. Well, are there any ones you like to do the best of all of them, or do you just like doing
them? The ones I love to do the best are the bravado singers. And I'm talking about, I like to do Billy Joel. That's good. I mean, I turn into Mr. Long Island at a heart's beat. And I actually have done shows as Billy Joel for Ford Motor Company in Manhattan. I mean, I put on the little curly wig and get that dark demeanor that Billy Joel was known for. Not the old bald-headed guy now. Sorry, Billy. But I do him from his earlier years, like Nylon Curtain, The Piano Man. I do him in those fashions. Tom Jones. Oh, man, I love doing Tom Jones shows because the ladies absolutely go crazy over Tom Jones. It's not unusual to be loved by anyone. You get that body going and they just love it. Or his, stablemate like Rod Stewart, Sir Rod. Oh, yeah, Rod Stewart. He's always popular. Mm-hmm. So, you know, you take all these acts. I like doing Johnny Carson because he was my cornerstone. And there's really not that many Johnny Carson tribute stars there are, you know. Mm-hmm. It's kind of like an open theater. Speaking of which, I noticed you had Tim Sells.
Mm-hmm.
Does
well, I haven't right. interviewed him yet, but he's in the future, but yes.
Angelo Capone, who does Jerry Lewis.
Right.
Dean Anthony, who does Dean Martin. Well, see, I just worked with those guys all down in Cape Coral, Florida, earlier this past year, 2020. I worked with them at Cape Coral at the Cape Cabaret, and also I did a show where I was with Johnny Carson and Rod Stewart for the Lions Club down there, actually the Moose Lodge at Fort Myers Beach, Florida. Mm-hmm. And Florida's been a big calling card. I did a big show in Siesta Key, Florida just recently, where I did my murder mystery, where I was Frank Sinatra, and he gets murdered. So who comes in and solves the murder? Pardon me, my name is Lieutenant Colombo. I'm LAPD, homicide. And I actually come in and solve my own murder. And that was in Siesta Key, Florida. So I look at my shows as being like a fun fantasy card game. Whatever face cards you want, I'll bring to your show, to your party, to your festival, to your whatever. So that's what I do.
Yeah, and of course you mentioned Angelo Capone and Dino Anthony. Yes, and I've interviewed both of them in the last few months.
All right. Well, I worked with them the first time down there in, at, like I said, Cape Coral, Florida.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to mention my websites, basically. I know you're going to have a demo, a video.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I was just going to ask you where everybody could find you at, and I guess you...
Here we go. Look at here. I come prepared. Here's my slate. Vegas Tributes. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Scroll at VegasTributes.com. And there's the number. It sounds like a Vegas number, but it's not.
Hmm.
It's 757-589-0903. So that's Vegas Tributes. Again, film stars, rock and roll stars, literary figures, historical figures. And then the next one is the Martini Men. Like old Shakespeare said, what's in a name? Well, the name, the Martini Men, gives you the impression of Las Vegas Classic Lounge, which exactly what it is. And again, same phone number. How you like that high tech?
Yeah, very impressive, I think.
Well, you know, it's funny. I'm also an aficionado of classic TV and movies. And I mean, going all the way back from the 1930s and 40s, 50s, all the genre of thrillers, detective comedies, and all the good stuff was done early because they were the lodestones. They were the gems. They were the solid nuggets of gold. They were so easy to find. Laurel and Hardy, the Three Stooges, the Marx Brothers,
mm-hmm.
their stuff was so pure, so funny because it was the easiest and most understandable comedy to be made. Later years, as we go into the new millennium, it's getting harder and harder to be an original comic. So therefore, I like to dwell in the classics. Classic comedy, classic music, classic theater, you name it. I think you can't beat great classics because they had style.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly. I mean, even now, every once in a while, I find myself watching The Three Stooges and, you know, some of those classics from the 30s and 40s, you know.
That stuff is so good. Well, but, you know, you take the matinee idols, you know, all the great films with Doris Day, Jack Lemmon, one of my favorite actors of all time, you know, and all the great actors you can learn and glean so much from. And even classic TV, I've suddenly become a fan of the old Perry Mason shows. I watch it in the morning and watch it at night because there's little nuances that they used in those things which didn't telegraph the story. But you could watch them and say, gosh, that was such a cool move. That was really cool. It's not explosions and special effects and computerized graphics. Not back then. They knew how to reach out there and grab you by the gray matter and make you think. So
yeah, exactly.
I
guess we're getting ready to watch one of your tributes right now. It's to Rod Stewart. Is there a little story behind that?
Let me explain this. I could have pulled 100 different videos out, just like the 100 different stars. I got 100 different videos on YouTube. All you got to do is say YouTube TBC Stars, which stands for Tim Beasley Celebrity Stars. Mm-hmm. But you can get any of my videos off my website. So take it the easy route. That's your finder. These two guys. Mm-hmm. You can find anything you want to know about me. 100 different celebrities, 100 different videos, right on the websites. Now, this Rod Stewart is an amalgamation of three different views of two songs. And people say, well, why'd you only do two particular songs in a demo? I say, because I want you to see the reaction of three different audiences for each one of these songs. Why? Because these are not staged. These are not theater. These are not done in a studio. This is a camera on a stick. Mm-hmm. A video camera you'd buy at Walmart and stick it the back of the room and hope nobody knocks it over or steals it. And I just stick the camera up and what you see is what you get. Mm-hmm. Now you watch Rod Stewart, the way that crowd reacts to him, how the people just, I mean, they go crazy. And you'll see him in three different venues. One was at the big Morley Hall at Secrets in Ocean City, one of the largest nightclubs in the nation. The other is at the Homestead, which is probably one of the most prestigious old resorts in America. And the other one was, you just watch and see. Oh, okay. We have a featurette. It's Tonight's the Night and Hot Legs.
Okay. Yeah, I was just ready to ask you. I knew Tonight the Night was one of them, but I couldn't remember the other one. So.
And Rod Stewart is only one of my 14 martini men. So if you want to see the rest, you want to see Tom Jones, Neil Diamond, Billy Joel, Frank Sinatra, Dean Martin, all that, go to the website, martinimem.com, and you can see all this. But anyway, hope you like it. Get a box of popcorn and your favorite drink, because it's about 9.5 minutes long.
Yeah, and we are getting ready to watch that in just a minute, but I want to thank you again, Tim, for coming on the show. Maybe one day we'll have you back, and you can do one of your characters or something like that. We'd love to have you.
Yeah. Like I say, it's all my diversified, just like a good stock portfolio. And by the way, Angela, hello. Hi, sweetie.
Angela Marie Monroe, he's talking about.
Okay.
Works for AMC Productions, which has some tributes there. So I want to say hello to her as well. And so let's get right to the act here as him as Rod Stewart. And we'll talk to you next time. Bye-bye.
Thank you so much. Enjoyed it.
Take off your shoes. We have Julia and Susie, and what's your name?
Elaine.
Elaine. Oh. Don't try this at home, Susie says. All right, here we go.